Thank you. Imagine a world where you are integrated with a computer to navigate the environment, like this. Actually, no, less tech. Like this, but more discreetly. Okay, how about this? But wait, is this just an electric bike? It's not. Let me tell you why. In this work, we explore integrated exertion. This is the design space at the intersection between human-computer integration, where the user and the system cooperate in a partnership, and exertion support, where the user invests physical effort as part of the user experience. And in the experience of integration, the system is constantly sensing and interpreting data in order to act in the experience. And the data that we explore in this work is the user's neurological data read via EEG from the occipital region. That is the orange part on the back of the brain responsible for vision processing. Reading this data can tell us when a user is or is not in a state of peripheral awareness in real time. And this is what we built.
Introducing Enna, a novel system that affords rider e-bike integration via the rider's neural activity. Via an EEG cap, Enna monitors that the user's neural activity is between 0.76 and 1.19 microvolts within the high alpha range of 10 to 12 Hz. These correspond to the rider's field of view being peripherally open to afford higher awareness of the environment, and it activates Enna's engine support. Instinctively, the rider's field of view narrows as a response to a threat, such as a car veering. In this case, Enna instantly stops engine support, allowing the rider more time to respond to the situation. With this work, we imagine a future where interactive systems are integrated with our neural activity to support enjoyable and safer experiences.
We studied our system with 20 bike riders and derived themes and design tactics around designing integrated exertion experiences with neurological data. We invite you to take a read at the paper for more details. Now I'd like to focus on a few takeaways from this work. Takeaway 1. Our work introduces and demonstrates peripheral awareness as a neurological state to HCI. This is a new approach we can use to study users of our systems through a non-invasive neurophysio lightweight and real-time approach. For example, to inform future health integrations that help users in developing practice to reach peripheral awareness and have a deeper understanding of their abilities. Takeaway 2. Changes in a user's field of view relating to peripheral awareness can be read in real time to gain access to a user's pre-attentive state. This means that the system is reading directly from the user's brain, and it can react faster than what it takes a user to react to the situation. And this is particularly valuable in different situations, such as navigating the environment, operating machinery, emergency response, and team operations, where the user benefits from having a wider awareness of the environment. Takeaway 3. Integration directly from the user's brain can facilitate a symbiotic-like experience. And to talk about this, I'm going to use this chart from previous work, where we see the system as an equal to the user. In this case, the user and the system have their own sensing abilities that complement each other. In what Farouk and Grudin called working as partners, and partners implies two agents. However, Mann previously said that once computer systems reach more advanced abilities, the divide between the user and the system was going to blur, and the user and the system would become one. In light of this vision, we see now in this work, the system and the user are one. And because in the 60s, Linklater also told us about the speed mismatch and language problem as obstacles in the symbiosis vision. And users of our systems said that they didn't need to think how to communicate or raise attention of the system, as it was directly from their brainwave. So the user and the system became one. Lastly, this approach contributes to Rekimoto's call on extending the toolkit of human-machine integrations available to us. So with this, we have begun to blur this divide between the user and the system. My take-home message is: using peripheral awareness as a neurological state for human-computer integration is viable, and it offers access to a user's pre-attentive processing state that the system can act upon to support the user experience. With that, I'd like to thank you for your time, and I'm happy to take any questions. Thank you.